Hey everyone, we're diving deep into the latest buzz in the AI world, GPT-4o. We tested the new model GPT-4o side by side with the older one, GPT-4. One interesting fact is that for now, GPT-4o will be available for free users, making this test even more relevant. However, there are still some benefits for paid users. They won't need to wait in line if there are insufficient resources, and they won't be switched back to the GPT-3.5 version in that case. Additionally, as a free user, you'll have limited access to some advanced tools for GPT-4o, such as data analysis, file uploads, browsing, discovering, using GPTs, and vision. But what exactly does this mean? Let's find out. One more piece of information. I will leave all the prompts that I used in this video in the description, so if you'd like to try them out for yourself, they'll be there. Research capabilities. We tested GPT-4o and GPT-4 on how well they handle complex research prompts. Here's what we found. We asked both models about how AI disrupts the IT industry, looking for specific use cases, benefits, and challenges. GPT-4o impressed us with its detailed breakdown and practical examples, like AI-driven tools improving IT operations and cybersecurity. There's also a nice little option right there. You can change the model in the same chat, so there's no need to open a new chat. I'll just change the model to GPT-4 and get different results for the same prompt. GPT-4 wasn't far behind, but sometimes lacked the depth and examples that GPT-4o provided. So, for research completeness and accuracy, GPT-4o takes the lead. Text summarization. For the summarization test, I will use a text from our previous research test. I will use the version generated by GPT-4o. Okay, I will write a prompt, and here we go. GPT-4o provided summaries that were spot on in tone and length, while GPT-4 sometimes strayed into promotional language or missed the mark on the required tone. So, for text summarization, GPT-4o again comes out on top. Writing text. When it comes to generating new text, like writing product descriptions, both models performed admirably. However, GPT-4o's output was slightly more polished and user-friendly, making it better suited for creating content that needs to resonate with an audience. Now, let's talk about multimodal understanding. This is where things get really interesting. We tested both models with image analysis tasks. For this test, I will use an image from the GPT-4o webpage showcasing audio translation performances. GPT-4o accurately converted image data into a clean table format without misinterpreting the GPT-4o name. In contrast, GPT-4 made a few mistakes in naming models. GPT-4o was named GPT-4, Seamless M4T V2 was named Seamless WMT 14 V2, and Audio Palm 2 was named Audio Palm 2. This precision can be crucial for tasks requiring visual data interpretation, especially for large data tables. For those of you into creative tasks, we also checked out image generation capabilities. We asked both models to create an image of an AI and an IT worker collaborating. I think that it will be interesting for this video. After all, we started with a prompt about IT workers and AI. GPT-4o delivered a more visually appealing and conceptually accurate image compared to GPT-4. This makes it a better choice for projects needing high-quality visuals. GPT-4o was faster and provided a more user-friendly format, but GPT-4 included direct links next to each point, which is better for detailed research work. Both have their strengths, but for quick, actionable insights, GPT-4o edges ahead. Looking ahead, what can we expect from OpenAI? There are speculations about the development of GPT-5, which could bring even more advanced features and improvements and bring us closer to Q-Star, or artificial general intelligence. We'll keep you updated on all the latest developments. So, what's the bottom line? GPT-4o offers significant improvements in several areas over GPT-4, especially in research completeness, summarization, and multimodal tasks. However, if you're a free user, I assume that access to the new GPT version will be severely limited. Currently, I don't have access to GPT-4o in my free account, only in my paid one, so I can't test this. But if you're not a heavy user and only need GPT occasionally, perhaps the free account will still suffice for you. So, in the end, this is exciting news for free users because they will have the opportunity to use a premium GPT model, even though with some limitations, but it's a much better model than GPT-3.5. That's it for today's review of GPT-4o. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth analysis on the latest in cybersecurity and AI. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.